So this is what it looked like before.
By that, I made a mistake, you know, like I was just trying to recorrect it. So I redid my whole hair again with the same color remover, which is the second big mistake I made, and I should have never used it again.
And this is what it looks like now. So on the last video, you guys saw my runes. A lot of people commented, and I appreciate everybody that commented because it helped me, motivate me to start this video.
I ruined my dreadlocks. Do this.
I don't just stop what I started. I keep pursuing it till I get it. So I'm that type of person that will continue to push myself, continue to push the limit, continue to grow, never give up. I decided to grab some of the bleach that I have left over from other bleaches that I've done previously. When I buy it, I usually buy it in bulk because I knew how many times I bleached my hair. And also for the clients that I have, sometimes they want to bleach their hair. I know what works with bleach. I don't have to go to a professional to get bleached. Actually, I do way better bleach than a professional person can do. And I can promise you that 100%. I've done it on myself 6-7 times. I've done it on other people's 3-4 times. And so I have the experience that I need over the past 2 years. The thing that I made a mistake about was the Oops Corrector, which I should have went with my guts and just used a regular bleach, because if they're not using a bleach on their packet, then I don't know what the heck is in their packet. And I think that's what really affected me, because them trying to compensate what bleach can do, they put a lot of different nasty things in there that made my hair bad. But also, you guys, the color Oops worked for, glad for you. I tried rinsing it out. I tried doing this and that, the third and the fifth, and you know, it just ruined my hair. If you had a fading green like mine and you go into a black, guess what? You don't really need to bleach it a long time, because black will overpower it. Of course, it will give it a little bit of color that you don't need, and that's where this bleach comes. And half of the time that you usually put on a regular bleach is what you put just to take off the hair color. You always want to grab gloves, because bleach will end up eating your skin. If you use your skin, your hands, it will literally, you will feel heat on your hands. Even if it gets on your forehead, you have to be able to avoid getting it on your skin. And some people put Vaseline on their head for extra protection on their skin, which is a smart idea. Also, if you're a person that don't know what you're doing and this is your first time, I've been doing this for a while. So with dreadlocks, especially me bleaching half of my dreadlocks, usually is how it goes. If you bleach in your whole head, be careful, because you will end up touching your scalp, and your scalp is very sensitive. And guys, I don't recommend nobody to touch their scalp, so please avoid your scalp. Just use it, just do your hair, man, and go about at least closer to your roots, but an inch or two away from it, because you do not want to touch especially your baby hair or the roots of your hair in general. And that is a fair warning because I've never done that before and I will never do that. I want my baby hairs to last. I don't want to go bald before that time comes. Bleach gives your hair overheating power. As you, of course, put it in a bag, it gets pretty hot because with heat comes expansion on the bleach, thus resulting for it stripping out the hair color or the dye that you have on your hair. What bleach does to a hair that's never been bleached before is strip away the melanin that's on the hair. The melanin is what gives your hair the color black or brownish, whatever color that you have in your hair. That color naturally that comes from the melanin, and a bleach just takes that away, thus causing the proteins and the nutrition that it has in your hair to strip away. And that's why I also recommend to use oil or moisturization products to help out strengthen your locks or your hair after bleaching. Once you put it in a bag or a plastic or a foil, whatever you have, you want to time it for about 20 to 30 minutes if you have never done it before, if this is your first time. And if this is something that you're just using to remove the hair color, which I've done before, I should have just trusted my guts in the previous video, then use half of that time, so about 15 minutes. So that's what I'm going to do, 15 minutes for the sets of lock to bleach. After waiting 15 minutes, you want to rinse it thoroughly at least up to 20 minutes to get all the bleach out, because bleach is very powerful. As I told you, as time goes on, it keeps expanding, thus causing your hair to be eating by it, especially if it's inside your hair or your dreadlocks. So please, guys, rinse your hair thoroughly. If you have a Shimmer Light shampoo, this is the best opportunity also to use it, but just don't ever use it with a color remover, because that's part of the problem in the last video that resulted my hair to turn the color to bluish, because purple shimmer shampoo is actually a purple color and it actually has a dye effect / a bleaching effect to the hair, but it comes with a lot of protein and conditioner with it. So it's good whenever you're just bleaching your hair, but if you're color removing it, don't ever use the shimmer shampoo together because it doesn't combine well. Yes, I ended up recovering my hair. This is the result that came out. I'm very happy. Thank you guys for the support. Love y'all.
All right, guys, I was able to accomplish it. I was able to get the platinum blonde back on again. You guys can see a little bit of the blue around it, but that doesn't matter because the next color will overpower what I'm doing with this. And yeah, this is it, guys. I'm so thankful for y'all for encouraging me. In the last video, a lot of you guys' comment was very, very helpful. And I was glad to see even TP Lox, coming in and saying some things about what he dealt with and how he said he vowed never to bleach his hair again. That's dope as heck, because I'm not the type of person that can vow something like that, because if I vow, it is what it is. Like, that's how it's gonna stay, man. And so I have vowed, to grow my undercut, and that's the next video I'm gonna be talking about. I have a whole, hopefully 3 inches undergrowth. But before I even, let you guys go right now, because this is the end of the video, before y'all click off, man, I want to say thank you for the encouragement, for everything, because I mean, look where it's at right now. Like, yesterday I thought it was going to fall off. Today, the recovery is amazing. A week-long process of, moisturizing my hair and different things like that to get it where it's at. Of course, I just now bleached it, so it's not good for the hair in general, but for the gold that I have, it is perfectly there. It is not bad, it's not ruined, it's not destroyed completely, so I'm excited for that. Probably going to be my last time that I apply a bleach to my hair. When I say probably, I gotta be careful, because maybe one more time, but like, I'm almost done, okay? So guys, like, I had goals with this sets of lock, and I'm accomplishing. With the last video, it looked like it was terrible, it was bad, and I thought I was done really completely, but with your motivation, I was like, you know what, I can do it. And even before that, I was like, I was like, I'm not gonna give up. I can't give up. If you give up, if you quit or give up, you failed then. But if you continue to go, even if you fail, then you really didn't fail. You just had the best opportunity to try to do it and accomplish again. So this is what it looks like. I'm gonna give you guys a close-up look. Like I said, it's not the most perfect thing ever, but this is what it's looking like. Like, last video was terrible. Like, this one, it looks like, a regular platinum blonde. It's wet right now, that's why it's kind of like, the bottom is kind of like twirling and stuff. Once you blunt tip these things, it'll be fine. Mostly it happens even with regular dreadlocks, like you getting these type of things after you wash your hair. But yeah, the color is off. Look at that, man. It's platinum blonde, literally. Yeah, last one was not it. So this is what it looked like before. Like that, I made a mistake, like I was just trying to recorrect it. So I redid my whole hair again with the same color remover, which is the second big mistake I made, and I should have never used it again.
And this is what it looks like. I'm super happy with it. I'm super glad with it, man. Thank you guys for every support that you guys have made. I appreciate y'all so much. Without y'all, I wouldn't be able to do this and make this. But for the next video, it's gonna be a new set of color. I'm excited to announce it on the next video because it's gonna blow your mind away for sure. I'm happy. Thank you guys for watching this video. I'm uplifted. My goodness. Till next time, keep acting diverse and creating your universe, man. I'm Activerse and I'm out.